See, the people always need a change. So in my last election, I proved myself because I was in MUMB as a mayor for 3 terms. So people saw my work in MUMB city as a mayor. So that's why people choose me. Because I have solved the basically water problem of my city. That was very important for MUMB. So people got 24/7 water, transportation. So always if you are working in a positive way, so people support you. So this was my plus point.
So what is more important to you, the money or
what? See, money is important, but see, money is for a betterment of city. That is, if you want to develop something, so you need money. But before that, we need planning. For Hiranandar city, we need good planning. MMRDA is working for that. So after the plan, municipal corporation plan, I am thinking to bring more money for this river Hiranandar city. So where we can have a lot of projects, JNMRM projects, where we will get more water supply, then transportation, then bridges, then monorail, then metro rail, then car park. So these are the projects where the government of India and government of Maharashtra are going to spend the money. So I am trying to bring more money for this Hiranandar city.
About a challenging situation you have faced. What was the situation and how did you cope up with it?
See, it depends on the situation. What type of problem is there?
Yeah.
Like we want to develop these two railway station of Hiranandar. That is in others railway station. So earlier that was not passed by the central government. And they were saying that no, we will not going to pass this two railway station as a other railway station. But then I pushed up that matter. I took this matter to the Mamata Banerjee. Means whenever you need the planning, so I planned that I will definitely bring this two railway station in the other railway station. So you need efforts, hard work. So then you will going to achieve the goal. So like that, this is the example. In the last 20 years. People are trying to bring this railway station in the international standard railway station, Thana, and Hiranandar as a other railway station. And in my 1 year period, I did that.
So, what type of cooperation do you expect with your co-worker, father and brother?
Definitely, they are my right and left. Like, because father, he is always with me. All up and downs. When I have fought this election, earlier by election, and I lose that election. But that time he gave me support and you don't worry, you go ahead. And after 1 year, the people support like anything. They gave us support in the election and the victory was there. My younger brother Sandeep Naik, he is looking after the Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation. Even though he is from Airoli as a MLA, but he is looking after the entire Navi Mumbai. So I don't have any tension about the Navi Mumbai people because he is there to look after. So that burden is now, suppose if you see the 33% Navi Mumbai, 33% Mahindra, 33% Thana. So 33% load is taken by him. So I don't have that much problem about the Navi Mumbai. So I can, you know, come any time to Navi Mumbai, Thana and Hiranandar. So not like a brother and a father, but they are really my two hands and legs. because of them I can, you know, work 24/7. So definitely their moral support, their support is there. So that's why I achieve these things.
How have you solved the problem of 145 Mirabagh in the constituency, like dumping ground for garbage, bad condition of road and uncovered nala in the maximum areas?
Actually, see, every city needs a planning. Mirabhayandar city, it's an adjoining city of Mumbai. But same time, Navi Mumbai is also a planned city in adjoining to Mumbai. But if you see, there is a lot of difference between two cities. The lack of planning. So we need to plan the city with the infrastructure, like your big roads, drainage, sewerage. So definitely, I will try to bring more money in a scheme of JNNARL. So there is a scheme for this Municipal Corporation Mirabhayandar, given the city development plan, CDP, which we are going to apply for the next 10 years. So accordingly, the corporation will going to develop their infrastructure. So for that, my planning is there to bring at least 500 crore rupees for this project. So after that investment, we will have a closed nalas, then big roads, then water supply to the adequate water supply to the municipal corporation area. So we are trying to see that within a next year, within a 1 year, we will see the not I will say 24/7, but at least 12 hours your Mirabhayandar people will get a word thing.
So, how do you feel that your majority candidate win in NMMC?
Yeah, definitely that is the hard work of Mr. Ganeshji Naik sir and our all party workers, because this is not a one day victory. This is not a one day effort, because this is a plan of next 50 years. So you will see that the Navi Mumbai Municipal Corporation will going to, the people of Navi Mumbai will going to support Mr. Ganeshji Naik and our Naik family for next another 50 years because of planning. So I think the people gave support to the development. People saw what development is going on. And apart from caste, religion, state, people gave support. Whether that is from Muslim community, Christian community, Hindu community, people said this is Ganesh Naik's candidate, we will support. So like that, they support to that candidate and we got a ample means, one third majority, out of 90 we got 60 corporates.
Okay, why politicians are more concerned of local language than Hindi as a national language, and whether this type of thinking going to divide
that? I don't think if you ask me, then I don't think this is an important subject on the national ground. Definitely, that is a locally. If this is Maharashtra, we should. You know, honor the Maharashtra people, Marathi people. But same time, we have to honor the our national Hindi language also, because more and more people knows Hindi language. So we don't. I don't want to, you know, divide these people in the language wise. You are Maharashtrian, you are non-Maharashtrian. So I don't think anybody will like this. So I am supporter. That we have to honor the Marathi people. But no, you shouldn't, at the same time, you should not discriminate, you should not, you know, hate Hindi people. You have to support them because this is a integrated Hindustan. This is a, means we have to maintain a communal harmony. So I think we should get together, we should call together, and we should work together with the all religious, all the languages people. And we want to develop this city. So. We should not have this difference, language difference.
Sir, what is your comment on Gilbert Mandonka as an MLA, whether he will be able to serve in the public of Mirabhayandar?
Definitely. See, he was the first chairperson of this Mirabhayandar Corporation, Municipal Corporation. Earlier that was council, but later on, Myra Mendonca, wife of Gilbert Mendonca, she got opportunity to become a first mayor, ready mayor of this town. And then later on, he got as the first MLA from this Mirabai. So definitely, the capacity is there, potential, he will definitely serve the people. And as a being a MP, my duty is there to support him. And both myself and Gilbert Mendoza, we will see that, we will try to solve the more problems from this your Mirabai seat.
Sir, do you have any plan to suggest to government, state and center for unemployment and starvation?
Yeah, definitely, because nowadays we are suffering a lot because of the globalization.
Yes, sir.
Then your privatization and multinational companies are coming here, but they don't have, you know, a proper employment system. Because nowadays everything is on a contract basis. So there is no surety of permanent job. So we are trying to give the suggestion to the government of Maharashtra and Central. They try to give your sure and long-term job, not a contract job. Because maybe you are there for 1 year, maybe you are for 2 years, but we want a secure job. So people will, you know, have a mind in their mind that yes, peace of mind that yes, I am working here, so I'll be there for next 10 years, 20 years. But there is no surety. So our idea to give more employment, and same time we want to give if people want to, this government want to develop this private contract system. So we will sit and give more money, more salary to the people. So where they will, if no problem, if they are not a permanent job, but they will earn more. So they will put some portion from that their money for their next future. So this is our suggestion, that if that is there. And secondly, we want to give more support to the IT people, IT, telecom. So where you can give a more job to the young people, youth, newcomers, new generation. So we are trying to bring a more industry in Mirabai in terms of BPO, call center, information technology, IT center, then your telecom. So these are the service sector, service industry. We want to develop a service industry in Mirabai.
So, have you weighed the UPA government location of first year company?
Definitely, see, kabhi khushi kabhi gham. But I will definitely support the UP government, because right to education. This was the first unique project passed by the government of India. Then 50% reservation in the local bodies and 33% reservation women in the state and central. These two major decisions taken by the UP government, I must congratulate Honorable Prime Minister Manmohan Singh Ji, UPA Chairperson Sonia Gandhi Ji, and our dynamic leader Sharad Pawar Ji, who really served the people in last 1 year. We are trying to solve more and more problems. If you see the women's side, first time we gave the women special train from Thana to Navi Mumbai, Thana to Panvel, Thana to Mumbai, suburbs, locals. So this was happened first time. So very soon we will going to have a youth special, means youth students, they will particularly period, say college period, school period, they will have a special trains. Then 24/7 gas supply to the every citizen in Mirabai. So central government, and secondly senior citizen, who are trying to give, you know, after 60, they should, because your hands are not working in properly. So after retirement, people want assurance that till end I will enjoy my life peacefully. So for that they need a financial assistance. If somebody has got, you know, any health problem. So if the poor person is there, nobody is there to take care of that person. So the government duty is there. So government have decided to make a 2 lakh rupees life your insurance. So where we will have a 200 disease covered by this insurance policy. For this new insurance policy is coming for the senior citizens. So these are the major things which are coming with the UPI government.
So how your party and your personal opinion on IPL issue related with Shri Sharad Pawar, Rahul Gandhi, Supriya Sule and
See, you people should not bring politics in this, you know, sports games. Okay, no problem. These are the people who involved. Real the people behind this new, you know, era in the cricket matches, in the cricket game. When there was a, you know, test match, then some people said that we need one day. Then after people said no, we want 2020. So then people said okay, we want IPL, men's league. So we should say that we have to encourage the all games. Sharad Pawar was the earlier he was the chairperson, but now he is no longer with the any association of the cricket matches or this. But I think some people are trying to pull them in this matter. But I know that they are not involved in this directly in the IPL, but some people want to spoil their name. But as a worker of NCP, who are behind the Sharad Pawar and their family, and our support is there. These people are not, some people want to do, you know, PT politics. So we are saying that these people are not like that. If they want to earn money, there are so many other business are there from where they will get a more money. This is not a way to earn. So some people are there, means my summation is there, that you, after some period you will come to know what is the fact.
Okay, sir, Skyhook extension near Mira Road railway station and urbanization of Mira Road, Mira and Binder still keep it away from parameter of cities and its development, which is essential. Which is not yet achieved.
So yeah, that is there in last meeting of MMRD, we have given this proposal. So that's why I told you, know, we want a plan of the city.
Yeah.
Next 10 years, what will going to happen with the Mira Road? What will going to happen with the east and west? What type of new development are coming? So we want to make sure to the public that yes, after 2 years you will get this, after 3 years you will get this. So we want to assure the public. So that's why we need a good plan of this town. So in future, we, if there is any skywalk, monorail, metro rail, these are the need of the city.
Okay.
So there is a planning to extend these all projects in the nearby. I think maybe in a couple of 1 year, we will see the all extension of these new projects.
So what do you think the central government should take initiative about the global warming and change of the climate?
Absolutely. This is the responsibility of central government as well as state government, and as well as I will see it's a responsibility of every citizen of this country. You should not say like that government will going to take care of it. After all, this is our government. This is the DEMA process, so people should aware about that, and people should support the projects, programs to the develop this global warming. So this is alarming for the next 100 years. So if you will see that positively, the government of India is really working on this, Mr. Jairam Ramesh, the Central Environment Minister, is working on, seriously working on this. In the Copenhagen summit, he explained his ideas and future planning about our country. So our country head, Prime Minister Manmohan Singh ji, Sonia Gandhi ji, all ministers and all MPs who are very much concerned about this global warming, and you will see that within a 5 years period these things will be going to resolve, and slowly you will see the pollution, we have to control the population growth also, we have to focus on the more environment issues, we have to plant more trees in the countries, we have to stop the encroachment, and we have to put the plantation on the vacant places, so where you will have the more environment impact. About the mangroves also, we have to protect the mangroves also. So So like that we are trying to support the environmentalists and environment people and environment department.
So CRZ, ND zone and Solpen, that's the building issue in the Mirabai
and
Telangana territory. How are you preparing?
As a member of parliament, I have given the proposals to these concerned authorities, and it's a time-consuming matters because here the central government assistance is required, and these issues are we have to take from last 10 years these problems are talking and working on paper, but on the reality ground the central central government as well as your High Court and Supreme Court. The matter is with the Supreme Court and High Court. So we are trying to push this matter in the High Court and Supreme Court because these two authorities will be going to, you know, give the guidelines related with the Solpen. Solpen issue is not with the Supreme Court, High Court. That is resolved by the ministry, and the Sharad Pawar is the head of that department who will be going to resolve this. Related with the CRZ and mangroves, the environment issues are with the department, but the Supreme Court had given some directions, some guidelines. So accordingly, these are in the pipeline. So within a couple of months, we will going to resolve these problems.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving your precious time to us.
So nice. So nice.
Thank you.
Two important work items. So I just take 2 minutes of yours before you go to Thala.
Yeah,
first thing is I sent you a thank you.